Again, we welcome you from Calvary Church in the city of Vicksburg. We pray for the Lord being in our lives, even in a time of crisis. We ask you be prayerful as we move through this time. Our scripture reading this morning will be coming from the Gospel according to John. Fourth chapter, and I'm going to read from 27, John 4, 27, and following. Just then, his disciples came. They were astonished that he was speaking with a woman. But no one said, "What do you want?" Or, "Why are you speaking with her?" Then the woman left her water jar and went back to the city. And she said to the people, "Come and see a man who told me everything I have ever done. He cannot be the Messiah, can he?" They left the city and were on their way to him. Meanwhile, the disciples were urging him, "Rabbi, eat something." But he said to them, "I have food to eat not know about. So the disciples said to one another, "Surely no one has brought him something to eat." And Jesus said to them, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to complete his work. Do you not say 4 months more, then comes the harvest? But I tell you, look around you and see how the harvest fields are ripe for harvesting. The reaper is already receiving wages and is gathering fruit for eternal life, so that the sower and the reaper may rejoice together. For here the same holds true. One sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you did not labor. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labor." Amen. The reaper. Verse 34, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to complete his work." My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to complete his work. One of the things that we struggle with today is the reality that when I look back over my life, there have been so many things that I've left undone. I don't know about you, but there are things that I've had dreams about, wondered about, hopes about, and they've only been things that have happened in my imagination. I can't tell you the times that I have thought I was going to do this. Let's talk about diet. Talk about food. Oh, how about New Year's resolutions? Oh, I'm going to change. I'm not going to eat what I used to eat. I'm not going to do what I used to do. I'm going to exercise like I didn't exercise before. You know, I'd have all these thoughts, but there was no plan. Sometimes, very often in my life and in our lives, we have these desires, and there's no plan. Jesus is sharing this conversation with a woman at a well who was a Samaritan. And that Samaritan woman challenged him in so many ways by saying, "Well, you know, you don't normally talk to me." But he says, "Yes, I don't normally, my people have not normally talked to you, but I do have something to offer." And then he continues to say that my food is to do the will of God. Sometimes in the midst of crises, God gives us opportunity, even more so, to do his will. So it's easy to celebrate God when the sun is shining. But how challenging is it to do the will of God when the day is cloudy? You know, very often we think that our plan is the right plan. Sometimes I have thought that, well, you know, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, but it's not about my will, but it is what? It is God's will. Very often we find ourselves trapped in our own decisions. And it is not that we're not to make any decisions, but I think it is imperative that we are prayerful. Even this time, as we face this crisis, this is not the first crisis that we've been through. I mean, you know, if you live in the United States of America, there are all kinds of crises and there are all kinds of issues. But when it comes to our house, this is what I always say, you know, when it comes to our house, our thinking changes the whole story. What we're grateful about today is that God, through Jesus Christ, tells us the food continues to remain the same. And that food is to do God's will. Each of us are called to do God's will, and our calling is unique to each of us. Maintaining faith is how we feed the will that we experience from God. I want you to know out there that we are going through the valley. David says, as I walk through the valley, I will fear what? No evil. No evil. Why? Because you comfort me. And there remains our peace today. The comforting will of God. The comfort of knowing that God is going to keep us, yes, Lord, even through this trial. Not long ago, our church experienced a fire. And I said initially that the fire comes as a way of purifying. And you know, God is purifying us right now. God is making us lie down in green pastures. You may say, well, my house is not a green pasture, Pastor. I want to get out and move. But you know what? Sometimes it is just good to be still. God says, be still and know that I am God.
Amen.
Now I'm grateful to the few. Let me count to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this, I want you to know that they're socially distant. But you know, people are socially distant in church most of the time anyway, right? I mean, you know, they very rarely see people come to the front of the pew. They most times sit in the back. So we don't have to necessarily change our ways, but we can change our behaviors through acknowledging that God is giving us an opportunity in the midst of this crisis. We have an opportunity to draw nearer to Him.
Amen.
Think of those things that we need to do for ourselves that we have not given ourselves time to do. Jesus says, my food is to do the will of God. But the second part of that phrase is, and to complete His work. Now I want to ask you today, what things do you need to complete? Oh my Lord, I'm glad my wife is around. I have a whole list of honey-do lists. But I don't know whether I can complete that list. But maybe during this moment, I'll be able to at least knock off two or three more. Each of us has a list of things that we want to do. Maybe God is asking us to do those things right now. I want to ask right now, are there any prayer concerns? This is an opportunity for those who are in the sanctuary to lift up prayer concerns.
I just I pray for everyone who is in fear right now from this epidemic, this pandemic, and I pray that they use the time, as you said, to draw closer to God and to draw closer to family and friends and to remember what's really important.
Amen. Is there another? Yes, ma'am. Speak loud so folks can hear you.
My prayer is that God will heal the world of coronavirus. And two, it has to do with the word of God that says, when I come back, will I meet faith? Because at this point in time, almost everyone is in fear, panic. What is going to happen next? What is going on? You know? I don't know if there's a sign that Jesus is going to come, but my prayer is that He will meet us in faith. Yeah, we are still faithful to do His will.
Amen. God will meet us in faith and not fear. Is there another?
Some of our friends are feeling alone, you know, even though they have their families with them, but they're feeling alone in their home. And I just pray for their spirit. spirits that, you know, we are doing what we can with sending jokes over instant message and things like that. But prayer to lift people's spirits and to encourage them, give them peace.
Amen.
Amen.
My prayer is that we can, you know, we're so locked into our cell phone, many of us. Why don't you call at least 5 people today? And just say, I'm just checking in on you. I mean, 5 people that you don't normally call. Just checking in on you to make sure that everything is going all right. And also say, I pray for you. Please pray for me. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads. Merciful God, we are grateful for those who continue to pray in the midst of the crisis. We pray, O Lord, that as we humble ourselves, that when you come in our midst, that we are met. You are met with our faith as opposed to our fears. We ask, O Lord, that you rule our hearts and guide our thoughts as we remember the words of our Lord and Savior who taught us to pray together, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I would like for us to close this moment with Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Now, my brothers and sisters, we hope that we will have another live streaming for next Sunday. I want to remind those who are part of our regular Bible study that we'll have a phone-in Bible study this week on Wednesday, and you will be contacted by phone or by text or by Facebook. So we're grateful for your coming here today. Be of good cheer. God is with us unto the end. And now, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of God's Holy Spirit rest and abide with us and for those of us whom we love, both now and forevermore. Let every heart say,
amen.
Let me hear you again.
Amen.
And one more time for the Holy Ghost.
Amen.